Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to create a mind map diagram using the Angular diagram component. You will also learn how to customize nodes and connectors in this layout, increase horizontal and vertical spacing, expand and collapse child nodes, and change orientation. First, I open an existing Angular application where I've added the diagram component with basic properties like height and width. To learn more about integrating the diagram component into an Angular application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and description below. Let me run this application using the command ng-serve. The diagram canvas is rendered. Next, I'm going to create a mind map diagram using Syncfusion diagram component's automatic layout algorithm. Mind mapping is a highly effective way to organize your thoughts without worrying about order and structure. Look at this example. It is a mind map diagram that represents concepts related to creativity, brainstorming, and its various aspects. To create a similar layout, I will create a data source first by adding a file data.ts. And define the object named mind map data with fields like ID, label, parent ID, and branch. Each object in this list renders as a node. The ID field represents a unique identifier for each node. The value in the label field is displayed as the node's content. The parent ID field establishes the parent-child relationship between nodes. The branch field represents the position of the nodes in the layout. To bind this self-referential data to the component, I open the app component TS file. Import the data binding class and diagram component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. And inject that class into the diagram component. Then import the mind map data from the data.ts file. To bind this data to the diagram component, I need to pass them to the data manager constructor. So, I import the data manager from the EJ2 data package. The data manager can act as a gateway for both local and remote data sources, which will use the query to interact with the data source. Now declare the variable data of type object and assign the mind map data object to the data source property using data manager. To identify the parent and child nodes, I map the ID field from the mind map data to the ID property, and the parent ID field to the parent ID property. Now assign this data object to the data source settings of the diagram component. To create the layout, I import the mind map class from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. And inject it into the diagram component. Then define the layout by declaring the layout settings variable of the type object and setting the type property to mind map. I assign this variable to the layout property of the diagram. Look here, the mind map layout has been rendered with the specified parent and child nodes. However, the nodes are currently empty. Next, let's move on to node customizations like adding annotations, changing dimensions, and so on. To achieve this, I add the getNodeDefaults property with the callback method NodeDefaults. This method will be called whenever a node is created. I'll define this method in the app component TS file. This method receives the arguments of type node model, which contains node details for each node in the data source to customize it. Note that this node model class is imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. I'll create a variable node data and assign the node details received from the arguments. Next, I add the annotations property to the node object and assign the label field from the data source to the content property. Now the nodes are rendered with the specified annotations. To enhance the visual appeal of this layout, I customize the height and width of nodes, change their shapes, and apply background colors. For now, I set the node height to 50 pixels and width to 130 pixels. I have planned to render a path node type with a custom style for the root node. So, add an if condition to check whether the node branch is root. And then change its default rectangle shape by setting the shape type to path. Then add the data property and assign the custom shape path value. Also, I customize the style by setting the custom fill color and stroke width to 0. In the same condition, I check whether the node's branch is left or right to customize its shapes and colors. In the shape property, I check whether the node is not a root node and set its type to basic and shape to ellipse. Use the same condition to apply the styles to the left and right branches. In the else condition, I add style with custom fill color and stroke width as 0 for other nodes. Since I have applied different background colors to the left and right side nodes, I change the annotation color to white. Check now, all the nodes are customized based on the provided details. The root node is rendered with a custom path shape, right and left nodes in ellipse, and all other child nodes in the default rectangle shape. Also, the nodes are differentiated by the colors specified. Now I will show you how to customize connectors. I plan to use the Bezier connector segment. First, I add the getConnectorDefaults property and assign the connectorDefaults method that will be triggered when each connector is created. I define this method in the app component TS file where I receive two arguments, connector model to customize the connector, and diagram class to access the component's built-in methods. Note that this connector model class is imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. To render a Bezier segment, set the connector type to Bezier and remove the target decorator by setting the target decorator shape to none. Now I need to specify the ports for the nodes to connect. So, I define the function getPorts of type pointPortModel which was imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. Then define the two ports with appropriate offset X and Y values. Inside the nodeDefaults method, add these ports while creating each node in the layout. Next, I need to get the source and target node to customize the port. So, I declare a variable, sourceNode of type nodeModel, and access the sourceNode details by calling the getObject method from the diagram component and passing the connector source ID. I declare another variable, targetNode of type nodeModel, and get the node details by passing the connector target ID. In addition, declare the variable targetNodeData and assign the targetNode details for each connector. I add a condition to check whether the branch name is right or subright. Set the source port ID property to the second port by passing port index to 1 and target port ID property to the first port by passing port index to 0. For branches left and subleft, connect these two ports oppositely. I customize the connector style by setting the custom stroke color and stroke width to 3. Check now, the Bezier connector segment is rendered between each connector, and its width and color are customized. Next, I show you how to adjust the spacing between nodes horizontally and vertically. The default spacing between the nodes is 30 pixels. I set the horizontal spacing to 50 pixels and the vertical spacing to 20 pixels. Check now, the spacing between the nodes is customized based on the specified pixels. Now, I'll show you how to enable the expand and collapse icons in the nodes. Inside the node defaults method, I add the expand icon property and set its shape to minus. And also add the collapse icon property and set it to plus. See, clicking this icon, I collapse the child nodes and clicking again, expand them. By default, the mind map layout is displayed in a horizontal orientation. You can also render it vertically. Just set the orientation to vertical in the layout settings. Additionally, I need to swap the X and Y values so that ports will be connected properly. Check now, the mind map is rendered in a vertical orientation. So far, I showed you how to create a mind map diagram using the Angular diagram component. Additionally, I demonstrated how to customize nodes and connectors within this layout, change orientation and spacing, and expand and collapse nodes. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I've also included a link to see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.